Hi, this is Craig from Quality Insurance and Consulting. You may know me from this business, my music career, or perhaps my photo media business, Picks and Dubs. Either way, insurance is my primary industry, and I'm here to talk to you today about something that's a little difficult to talk about, but important to talk about, and it's self-care for when you have cancer or you know someone who does have cancer. Now, I've been talking a lot recently about Medicare and treatments and having the right coverages and so many things that make it a more comfortable journey if you do have a cancer diagnosis. If you didn't know, I was diagnosed with something called CLL, which is a blood cancer called chronic lymphocytic leukemia, about 4.5 years ago. I was on watch and wait for a little over 4 years and then started treatment earlier this year and been on and off treatment. This conversation isn't about that, just to give you a little history, because someone who's in the Medicare business world of representing carriers and helping people find the right plan and the best plans that will fit their particular situation, also being the patient, knowing what it's like to be on the other side of the coin, so to speak, with something that's a very serious and chronic condition. Good news is I'm doing great and I'm holding my own, but there's some things I've learned and some things I'd like to share with you about that. And I really call it self-care for when you have cancer or coping with cancer. And this is important for caretakers along with the people who have the condition and just friends and family. Things to be aware of. I think these might be some helpful things to keep in mind. The first thing is you just want to slow down a little bit. Take time for your mind and body to adjust to what you have just found out perhaps, or what you are continuing to experience. Life isn't all about the running after the dollar or pursuing your career. Sometimes the most precious things in life are the small things that happen between friends, family, or with a pet, or a place that you go with nature. And those are things that really focus on and kind of help take your mind off of your condition that can be extremely daunting, as I'm here to be a witness of, and or witness to, I should say. So it's important to just take some time, back off from everything and just slow down. If you miss a day here or there and you're gonna take some downtime, everything's fine with that. you're not gonna change the rest of your life because you've gotta make an adjustment to what's happening. Or as things progress with your condition, you may have some days you just kind of knocked out of commission. Anyway, I definitely have had that happen. Another thing to keep in mind, make time for yourself from the viewpoint or vantage point of doing things that make you feel good. Do things that are fulfilling. Do things that are on your bucket list. Make sure you're not just putting something off that you're gonna eventually get to, because you may not get there. So take advantage of every moment, every day, and do something positive for yourself, something that's enjoyable for yourself. Because statistically, you may not have as much time as you thought you did. I'm not saying this from a negative aspect. I'm talking from experience and from what you can actually do with this condition. Not everything about having cancer is negative. There's tons of positive things that happen because it changes your perspective. It changes your priorities. It changes the people around you. And it changes everything about what you can do with your every moment that you're still here on this earth. And hopefully it's for a long time. Same for me, for a long time. Well, that's the end of this episode. To watch the next episode in this series, hit this video right now. I've got another video queued up for you. It's a good follow-up to what you just watched. So you can click that link right here. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them below. Also, if you're getting value and enjoying the videos that I make, you can click the subscribe button below. Go ahead and click that next video, and I'll see you there.